Hi, welcome to AirTech Solutions. This is Shishan. Let's proceed with next video. Then how to interface I/O peripherals with I/O ports. So before proceeding interfacing, so I want to explain about the reset circuit. Here the microcontroller needs some mandatory connections. Whenever you are trying to use microcontroller for applications, so you should know about this reset circuit. The reset circuit is very clear for microcontroller. These are the some mandatory components. You have two connections across 9th pin. So the 9th pin requires external RC combination followed by switch. This is your capacitor and this is your resistor, and I am using one simple push button. This capacitor positive lead you have to give it to source, which is 5 volts DC, and 40 pin is a power supply pin for microcontroller. You have to connect 5 volts DC source across 40th pin. Then around 18 and 19 pins I am just connecting oscillator. This is a symbol for oscillator, and along with this series of oscillator I am just adding two capacitors which filters the noise, anything generated by oscillator, and 20th pin is ground. And also I am giving connection across 31st pin, which is EA, which is given to VCC. You should understand the importance of all these connections, why you need external RC combination across 9th pin of microcontroller, and across 18 and 19 you need to connect external oscillator. So this oscillator, I am just writing the values of each and individual thing. The capacitance, which is they are using 10 microfarad, and resistor which is 8.2 kilo ohm. And oscillator frequency is 11.0592 MHz. And two disc capacitors, which is 33 picofarad. So these are the individual values of all these components. So across 9th pin, I am just doing R and C, the series of button. Whenever you are operating this button, which is closed, then your capacitance and series will come to the series. That should be the discharging cycle of your capacitor. The functioning of this reset pin, so which is already discussed at pin diagram. The reset pin working is very clear. Whenever you are giving the pulse across 9th pin, the microcontroller is going to stop the current execution and allows to re-execute the program from beginning. So whenever I am providing positive pulse across this 9th pin, so this is the behavior. But how much time I need to provide this high pulse across 9th pin, so that should be followed by time constant formula. There is a time relation between time and resistance capacitance. The time constant formula T is equal to 0.6 constant, which followed by RC. So this is the time in seconds actually. So based on this, you need to provide a sufficient value of this R and C. So now you can apply your resistance on this formula, which is 8.2 kilo ohm, and capacitance is 10 microfarad, which is 10 power minus 6, which is seconds. So this time you will get mostly on milliseconds or microseconds. So this is the time taken by your microcontroller to reset itself. Say wherever it is, the current execution is wherever it is in memory. In terms of memory, if you take it, the microcontroller provides 4 kilobytes of ROM memory. The execution may be under any location, so it has to come back to the initial address of memory, which is 0000H. So you need to provide this sufficient time by giving this R and C combination. So that is the reason you need to connect external resistor and capacitor across 9th. then the importance of this crystal oscillator across 18 and 90. The oscillator is going to produce clock cycles. Without clock cycles, your program doesn't execute by the CPU. So this oscillator is generating clock cycles, and clock cycles are distributed for the internal activities of device. But I am working here with a specific frequency, which is 11.0592, as per supporting frequency range, which is 4 MHz to 40 MHz in between. But here you are finding a specific frequency, which is 11.0592. So with this frequency, there is a serial communication feature which is interlinked with this. If you are not looking for serial communication feature, you can use any frequency between this range. So because which is affecting my baud rate, so that is the only reason they are taking this 11.0592 MHz. Then here I am connecting two series capacitors. If any noise is generated by this oscillator, so which is filtered through this capacitor, because if you go with any embedded product, it has to work 365 days. So if you keep on power for these devices, so due to any temperature or overheat or any additional parameter, the oscillator may be disturbed with the noise. So if you don't want that, then you need to add these capacitors as filters. The 20th pin is your device ground pin, so I'm connecting with ground. And 31, which is EA. The EA pin functionality is very clear. If you are enabling this, your microcontroller attempts for external memory. So, but now I am trying to disable this EA pin by connecting with VCC, because it is active low pin. If you are giving VCC, then you are disabling external access. If you are trying to enable external access, then make it this EA pin to ground. So that you should be very clear on this EA connection. Either you have to connect with VCC whenever you are looking, you are not looking for external memory. If you are looking external memory, make it enable by connecting with ground. So whenever I am giving this EA pin to VCC, the microcontroller deals with internal memories. It doesn't look any external memories. So whatever the program present in the internal memory, it allows to execute. Then 40th pin is your device power supply pin. So this is as usual being connected with 5 volts DC source. This is the importance of all these individual connections. This is called as reset circuit of microcontroller. Now you can proceed for any application interfaces. Like you may work with any kind of interface, maybe LEDs, maybe keypads, maybe keyboards, or maybe sensors, or anything you are trying to connect with IO lines of microcontroller. Then after doing all these mandatory connections, you can do your external devices interfacing. So you need to understand what is interfacing from microcontroller. So generally, a regular connection, it is not an interface. If you are looking to interface, as an application developer, you need to focus on the two important characteristics of devices, which are V and I. You are connecting one device with another device. There is a one mandatory thing you need to follow before proceeding your physical connections with one device with another device, especially in electronics. So you should be very clear on these VA characteristics of two individual devices. So just by doing physical connection, it is not an interface. Until unless you are not aware of this VA characteristics of two individual devices, it is only regular physical connection, it's not an interface. But if you want to control one device with another device, or you are trying to pass your data between two devices, or you are trying to share your working information with two devices, you should be very clear on this voltage and current characteristics of two individual devices. Let's example. Like if you are trying to connect one electrical load with microcontroller. So as an application developer, it is possible to control my electrical load with controllers. But you should follow a standard circuit for that. Just by taking 2 wires of load with 2 IO lines from microcontroller, if you do it any physical connection, it's only connection, not an interface. If you want to do perfect interface between 2 devices, so you should be very clear on these characteristics. That is very important if you are proceeding for applications. If I am trying to connect my electrical load with microcontroller, I need to understand the characteristics of electrical load is very clear. It is working with 230 volts AC. And most probably it is taking some current in amps. Approximately maybe 1 amp or 0.5 amps or 2 amps, depends on the load. But whereas in microcontroller side, the microcontroller is working with other characteristics. It is working with 5 volts DC source. As current, it may provide 5 to 10 milliamps maximum from the IOs. So this is the way you need to understand. Whenever you are trying to connect any external device with microcontroller, you need to focus on these characteristics. So once you are very clear on these characteristics, yes, you can prepare proper circuit. See, the engineering will help you to work on it. Whenever I am connecting 2 devices, you may find so many resistors, so many capacitors, there are so many comparators or so many external components which is you studied in engineering. You are finding transistors, diodes, resistors, capacitors, inductors, op amps, DC to DC boosters, or converters, or ADCs, DACs. There are many devices which are present between 2 peripherals, between microcontroller and peripherals. So that's what you need to understand, the importance of those components whenever you are applying interfacing. So let's proceed with a simple interface with microcontroller. Now I am trying to connect a basic LED with microcontroller. So what I said, whenever you are proceeding for interface with any external peripheral with microcontroller, you should be very clear on the characteristics of your device. So now I am trying to connect LED with microcontroller. So as LED, you should be very clear on the characteristics of this LED. This is a symbol generally, and LED contains anode and cathode. These are the 2 leads of basic LED. What is the general behavior of LED in circuits? If I am providing positive supply across anode end and ground connection across cathode lead, it is going to turn on. So if you want to keep it off, I am just removing VCC across anode, then it automatically goes off. But VCC means how much voltage it requires to turn on the LED. The basic LED which is starts responding from 1.8 volts DC onwards. So this voltage you need to provide across anode lead of LED. Then it glows. But whereas microcontroller IOs characteristics are, they are always working on 2 voltage levels. From microcontroller IOs, logic 1 means 5 volts. If there is a voltage, so obviously you will find some current across IOs. Maximum current is 10 milliamps, which is V and I of IOs. Whenever you are making logic 0, so there is no voltage across IO lines, so 0 volts and 0 amps. So this is your IO specifications as per your microcontroller. But the external devices are working with different voltages and different current ratings. So you need to know what is the voltage, working voltage of LED or motor or sensor or anything you are connecting across IOs. So now coming to the LED, which is working with 1.8 volts DC source, which is some 5 milliamps current. These are the requirement of LED. Now I am looking to control this kind of LED with microcontroller. How to interface these LEDs? So generally, whenever you are trying to connect microcontroller with LED, most of the cases you will find resistors in series of LEDs. So now you need to understand the importance of resistor across LEDs, because the source voltage is higher than what peripheral is looking. So this is the resistance as per Ohm's law you can connect. This is a very simple connection. Most of the cases they will go with 100 to 330 ohm resistors. So this IO simple connection is required between microcontroller and LED, and just proceeding with series of resistor. And resistors are two ways you can connect with LEDs. If you are connecting resistor before to the LED with the IO line, and cathode LED is connected to ground. So this resistor is called as pull up resistors. The other way of connecting resistors in series with the LEDs, this is another way. So this resistor is called as pull down resistor. So most of the cases you will find resistors before to the peripherals or loads. If you are finding the source characteristics are similar with the peripheral characteristics, so the resistor which is or same or lower than your source rating, the resistor is connected after the peripheral. If the source rating is higher than your peripheral requirement, the resistor you will find before to the peripheral. So based on this, you need to apply your resistors in series. Okay, so this is how you can do the basic hardware connection with microcontroller and your simple LED. So by using these LEDs, you can do so many prototype applications like decoration systems or simple traffic signals or any kind of applications you can follow with the LEDs. So like you are looking for fountain shape, or you are looking for decoration systems, one by one formation. You can do multiple experiments just by doing this kind of hardware connection with the IOs. So this is very simple. Like if you are proceeding LED with IOs, make sure the resistance in series. The other way of connecting your LED with IOs, even you can operate LED with the logic 0 also, but for that you have to follow the connection like this. So I am just doing VCC and then LED cathode lead I am connecting with IO, which is P2.0. So this is also possible if you are looking LED with high contrast, like high brightness, because which will take the required ampere rating from the source so that your LED glows with high intensity. But here, if you are doing connection like this, whatever the ampere rating provided by IOs, so further the LED will glow as per current rating available from the IO. So this is how you can do your hardware connection with LEDs and microcontrollers. Thank you.